can't believe I didn't get promoted again. I can do this. Ah! See, I can be a Time Lord. You'll see, Master Lincoln. You'll see!
Dolan. Who knows what he told people? I'm gonna have to fix this. I'll need Master Wilczek's help. Kids. If you're a science buff, then you must have heard the buzz on the internet and in the media about an exciting sounding topic called time crystals. And it's completely reasonable that you might have immediately thought about such things as the British television show Doctor Who, the movie 12 Monkeys, or maybe even Thanos' Infinity Stones. Sadly, the reality is far less thrilling. It turns out that there's a bit of a disconnect between the name and the reality. That's not to say that real time crystals aren't an interesting scientific discovery. They're just not a way to zoom through time like Bill and Ted's most excellent adventure. Time crystals are actually a new kind of matter, one that repeats itself in time. You probably know about ordinary crystals like the ones you see here. They're beautiful. And they're not just beautiful to see. Their beauty goes all the way down to the molecular level, where the individual atoms in a vast lattice repeat in space. Time crystals are just when configurations of matter repeat themselves periodically. Now you have to be careful, as a planet orbiting the sun finds itself in the same place over and over again. That's not a time crystal. Time crystals occur when a bunch of adjacent atoms repeat their configuration over and over again. Time crystals were first proposed in 2012 when Professor Frank Wilczek of MIT described them in an article called Quantum Time Crystals. At the atomic level, ordinary matter looks pretty much the same no matter when you look at it. This is called having translational time symmetry. Wilczek proposed a type of matter that changed what it looked like over time. Look at it one moment and you see one thing. Look at it at a different time, and it looks different. And here's the key point, if you look at it at a fixed time interval, it would always look the same. Now, Wilczek imagined that these crystals would be perpetual motion machines, cyclically repeating their structure forever. However, shortly after that, two theoretical physicists by the name of Patrick Bruno from France and Masaki Oshikawa from Tokyo independently published papers that said that time crystals could only happen if the system was not in thermal equilibrium, which is just a fancy way of saying that time crystals can exist only if the energy of the system changes. In 2017, physicist Norman Yao and his collaborators published a paper called Discrete Time Crystals, Rigidity, Criticality, and Realizations, which described how to make a time crystal. And then the challenge was on. Since then, two groups, one at Harvard and one at the University of Maryland, have made time crystals. So what does a time crystal look like? Well, different groups have made different versions. I'll show you one to give you the idea. Suppose you had a string of atoms arranged like on a pearl necklace. Each atom has a spin associated with it, and these arrows represent the spin axis. In matter, at low enough temperature that the atoms aren't jiggling too much, the spin of the atoms tends to line up with one another, either pointing in the same direction or the opposite one another. They do this because it's the lowest energy way that they can arrange themselves. If the arrows, or spins, are pointing in different directions, this is a higher energy configuration, and, well, the universe doesn't like that. Now, you can hit the string of atoms with a laser. A laser is nothing more than an oscillating electromagnetic field, and that field forces the spins of the atoms to flip rhythmically with a laser. So far, nothing here is particularly interesting. That's pretty ordinary physics. It's kind of what you'd expect. the spin patterns of the atoms repeat themselves over and over again. Now comes the good stuff. What happens if you turn off the laser? The spins continue to flip, even though they aren't being forced to by the laser. And here's something that's even weirder still. You can use a more complicated laser to irradiate the string of atoms with a random electromagnetic field, and the atoms continue to oscillate the way they did when the regular laser hit them. So are time crystals useful? Well, possibly. There's a big hubbub in the physics and computation world about something called quantum computing. The problem with quantum computing is that, like all things quantum, it's easy to disrupt the quantum state, to peek in the box to see if the Schrödinger's cat is alive or dead, so to speak. However, time crystals have the ability to persist in their configuration, even when they aren't explicitly held there. Thus, it may be that they could form the basis of a memory for quantum computing. Or not. Nobody's really sure. The technology of time crystals and quantum computing are both still in their infancy. It'll be some time before we get this all figured out. So that's it. That's basically all time crystals are. I wish I could say that they were as sexy as their name, but I can't. Scientists will continue to study them and be fascinated, but the internet rumors of a time machine are, well, completely overblown. Okay, so time crystals. Great name, but they don't live up to the hyperbole. Remember, time crystals are a new type of matter and not a power source for time travel. Time lords aren't real, and there's no basis for the rumor that Fermilab and CERN house time lords. No basis at all. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, subscribe, and share. We want everyone to not fall for this ridiculous hype. I mean, it is all physics, because, of course, physics is everything. All right, you think they bought it?
You worry too much, Master Lincoln. The council is satisfied.